sustained pressure from both flanks as we launch a potential surprise tidal charge. Number 2, Ethan Ampadu leads from Chelsea. This one, as a Chelsea fan, I'm very excited for. We have produced a lot of talents, but Ampadu was always one of those I wish was given a chance because he's super talented. Already at 22, Ampadu has a wealth of experience. Two full seasons in Italy, a campaign at the base for Premier League midfield, as well as 44 caps for Wales. He even had a short spell in Germany with valuable Champions League minutes under his belt. All in all, the 7 million signing looks to be a great deal for a second tier club buying a player with time to improve. So far, he has been a steady anchor in Leeds' dramatic return to the Championship, putting together a string of solid performances. Ampadu has not scored in his professional career and much prefers to keep play moving and protect the space in front. A tenacious tackler, an increasingly resourceful passer, Ampadu will be a reliable, high-quality tempo setter throughout the season and a potential difference maker in a competitive race for promotion this season. Number 3, Bart Verbruggen, Brighton from Anderlecht. Few teams in world football can match Brighton for low-risk or high-reward transfers, though 21-year-old goalkeeper Verbruggen isn't their cheapest bill. A 16.3 million fee represents only 10% of what they raised from player sales this summer. The Netherlands under 21 international already seems to be possessing the unerring confidence and composure that every Brighton goalkeeper needs. A nerveless drag back under pressure from Anthony Gordon versus Newcastle, to go with his 50 completed passes was a snapshot of an extremely encouraging performance in his second Premier League game. Verbruggen made a rapid ascent through the ranks of Anderlecht last year, starting the season with their under-21s before starting for the first team on Boxing Day. 3 months later, he produced a heroic performance away at Villarreal to help his side through to the Conference League quarterfinals, making 9 saves in a shock 1-0 win. In the league, Verbruggen's shot-stopping prevented about 3 goals more than would be expected from an average goalkeeper. He faced a baptism of fire in his Brighton debut versus West Ham, but Verbruggen has shown he has more than what it takes to compete with Jason Steele for a place between the sticks. Is it too early to say that Brighton have done it again? Possibly, but nobody can argue with their track record for exceptional signings, and Verbruggen could be one of them. Number 4, Branko van der Boomen, Ajax from Toulouse. Last year, Toulouse midfielder Branko van der Boomen made a bold claim. In other areas, I'm perhaps not on the level of other players, but in terms of passing, few players in the world are as good as me. Fortunately, the data has his back. No outfield player completed more long passes or switches of play than the Dutchman last season, not just in Ligue 1, but throughout Europe's top 5 leagues. Few midfielders sweep the ball across the pitch with ease and regularity of Van der Boomen, a luxury tempo setup with an eye for defensive splitting passing. He made an astonishing 21 assists throughout Toulouse's promotion campaign in 21-22, before assisting in each of the 5 matches he played in. Last season's Coupe de France stripe, the first major trophy in the club's history. Only Real Madrid's Toni Kroos came close to replicating his unique combination of forward passing and creativity last term. Van der Boomen sailed to move to Ajax early in the summer and should be a perfect fit for their high possession style. The 28-year-old created 8 chances on his Eredivisie debut, and with new attackers Jupp Akpom, Carlos Borges and Georges Mikatadze, I have no clue how you say his name, sorry, likely to provide more forward runs for him to pick up, his assist should go through the roof. It's been a challenging summer in terms of outgoings, forward side, but their new midfielder should help to unlock deep domestic blocks and at least make a dent in the Europa League. And I could see him leaving for big things in a couple years. Number 5, Anastois Duvigas, sold to Vigo from Utrecht. Two players shared for Eredivisie's golden boot last season, one signed for PSG, and the other made a sudden switch to sell to Vigo. While PSG were triggering a buyback clause for Xavi Simons, Celta were weighing up a move for Duvigas, the Greek goal machine, who seems a remarkable transfer coup for Benitez's new side, bolstering their attacking options. The striker is a true poacher, having scored 15 of his 16 non-penalty goals from inside the area last season, and 6 of those were from within the 6-yard box. At 6'1", Duvigas is a danger in the air, but is most adept at turning close-range snapshots on either foot into powerful finishes. The 24-year-old has already spoken of his excitement to learn from Iago Aspas, but looks most likely to form a longer-term partnership with the talented Jürgen Strand Larsen. Celta were involved in an uncomfortable relegation scrap last season, saved by the goals of local boy Gabri Vega, who is now gone. Duvigas will be lurking to pinch those poachers' goals, hoping to extend Vigo's 12-season stay in the top flight, and under the guidance of an experienced top manager like Rafa, he could level up his game even more. Number 6, Matteo Retegi, Genoa from Boca Juniors. Now it has been quite the year for Retegi, following 30 goals across 2 seasons on loan at Argentinian side Tigre. 24-year-old made his debut for the Italian national team in March, despite never having stepped foot on Italian soil. He scored Italy's only goal in a defeat to England, and was later compared to Gabriel Batistuta by his manager. 4 months later, Amradeki has sealed a permanent switch to his adopted country, spearheading an ambitious project at Genoa upon their return to the top flight. A throwback target man, he arrives with an unmistakable reputation as a flat-track goal scorer. The early evidence suggests that Radeki won't have it all his own way in Italy. Genoa's 3 games have yielded just 21 shots and 0.9 expected goals, creating the fewest goal-scoring opportunities of any side in Europe's Big 5 leagues. Nonetheless, with an imposing physical stature and appetite for goals, Radeki is sure to be a striker who will dig in and feed off the scraps. Number 7, Sebastian Szyminski, Fenerbahce from Dynamo Moscow. Now, the Turkish Super League has a reputation when it comes to transfers, and might be one of the most interesting leagues in terms of transfers. Galatasaray have acquired 23-year-old Tete alongside Mara Cardi, Wilfred Zaha, Tanguy and Thombele. And Fenerbahce have added Cengiz Under, Dominic Livakovic and Fred as they look to wrestle back the Turkish crown for the first time in 10 years. But the best business of all looks to be the 24-year-old attacking midfielder Szyminski, picked at the peak of his powers for just under 10 million euros. The Poland international was crucial on loan at Feyenoord in their storming league drive under Arnie Slot last season, with only Santiago Jimenez putting up more goal contributions than his 12 in the Eredivisie, and already he has 8 goal contributions in a Fenerbahce shirt. Domestic success will be the main aim for Fenerbahce this season, but the Europa Conference League also presents an outside chance of a Continental Cup run, and this is where Sebastian Szyminski could be exploding. Watch out, Aston Villa. Number 8, Angel Di Maria, Benfica from Juventus. Much like in Turkey, Portugal's biggest clubs have made plenty of intriguing moves in the summer, with Victor Gyökeres, Orkun Kokcu and Ivan Flesneda all touching down in Lisbon. But even in the twilight of his career, 35-year-old Di Maria is the box office name. The winger continues to be a bundle of energy on the right flank, a nifty dribbler, and in 4 competitive starts for Benfica, Di Maria possesses that magic to win games all by himself. Although early, the Argentinian looks to be forming a lethal partnership with Rafa Silva, who has 5 goal contributions this season too. Benfica are their most dangerous when the two are close by. After 19 goal striker Gonzalo Ramos left for PSG, Di Maria will be a key source of attacking inspiration 16 years on from his debut with the club. Number 9, Vinicius Sousa, Sheffield United from Lomo. Following the departures of Illiman Ndai and Xander Bird, a return to the Premier League felt a daunting prospect for Sheffield. A single point from their opening has exacerbated those fears. Nonetheless, the arrivals of Gustavo Hamer and Cameron Archer are promising, and 24-year-old Vinicius Sousa is sure to be a reliable and very busy defensive midfielder who may have gone under the radar. The Brazilian has taken an unorthodox route to English football, joining Belgium's second-tier side Lommel, and since then he has been loaned to Mechelen and Espanyol, building his reputation as a destructive midfielder with a Spanish side last season. Only Real Betis's Guido Rodriguez made more tackles and interceptions than Sousa throughout his La Liga spell, and Sousa puts out fires all over the pitch. This guy is truly the definition of defensive midfielder, as he does literally all he does is tackle. Sousa has taken to life in England the only way he knows, flying into challenges across 4 committed displays. Whether it's enough to keep Sheffield in the division or not remains to be seen, but boys, to be sure, the Brazilian will become a fan's favourite. And finally, number 10, Sergi Dada, Mallorca from Espanyol. Another outgoing from the Espanyol team, but Dada is a great midfielder in a class of his own. A silky Spanish number 10 with the ability to glide into pockets of space. The 29-year-old carried his side's attacking responsibility on his shoulders last year. Not only did Dala complete more passes, dribbles, free balls and crosses than any other Espanyol player, he created 25% of their chances. He even made more ball recoveries than 97% of La Liga players. If anything, Sergi Dada deserved more for his industrious play, as his side were eventually relegated. Far too good for the second division, a summer move to Mallorca is exceptional business, particularly for a side who lost their creative force over the summer, league ganging to PSG. It does, however, look to be a deal that benefits the club more than the player. Only Hetafe have less possession than Mallorca this season, Even as they finished ninth last campaign. They were a side that thrived on defensive organisation and flashes of attacking inspiration, which may not suit Dada. Nonetheless, Dada will have complete freedom grade like Espanyol, but will be lacking consistent support in those creative zones. At least relegation shouldn't be an issue this time round. So those are the 10 under the radar transfers across Europe. But you need to keep your eyes on